What's up, fellas? I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today you are going to see the replay from the past, if I can say so. Like 1 month ago, I made a commentary on the tier 5 shitter marks T25, and you are going to see that today. And if you are wondering why, because I'm feeling like shit, and that was like our plan when we don't have anything to release. So you are going to see like 40 minutes of the Panzer. If you are interested in the lower tier gameplay, it's going to be for you. If not, then hashtag never lucky. The thing is, I have a flu, my nose is... Well, I believe you can hear that. I have a temperature and I'm looking like a shit itself. So today we are not streaming, and probably tomorrow we are not going to stream either. I apologize for that, but you know, health is number one thing, and it's the biggest priority of every single of us. So I hope you are going to enjoy the Panzer replay, and let's roll, fellas. What's up, fellas? I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we have a lower tier shitter gameplay. Once again, skill, how dare you? T25, third mark of excellence battle, and T25, 100% mark of excellence battle. Easy peasy, just like this, and you are not going to see this tank for a very long time in this channel. Another lower tier shitter which you can expect is probably going to be Turan. Yeah. That, but I think I'm going to make only one video on that tank, unless for some reason I'm going to get a lot of amazing gameplay, which probably is not going to be the case. Anyways, what we are going to do here, fellas, easy peasy. We are going to take a standard bush over there, which is very, very standard. Everyone knows that. And from this position over there, you can pretty much do whatever you want to do, right? What do I mean by saying that is you can cover the people which is playing up here, right there. You can cover people which is... well, you can hit people which is playing over there, and even over there. Basically, it's a key position. It's very, very nice one. One of the shitter things which you can expect sitting right there is blind shots. From time to time, people is blind shotting over there. Or alternatively, you can expect some free gifts like this cover one. I don't even know what I'm supposed to say. I don't know. I mean, he have zero Fs given, and he's looking at me, I'm saying, no, no. He's thinking. Tunged into the lower plate, and we are moving back. The funnest part of all this, I'm not spotted. Damn it, I was almost right, fellas. I was almost right, but yeah. Well, apparently I got spotted. It's okay, but probably it was not because of this cover one. Maybe it was because of that T67, because this cover one, from his playstyle, what he's doing right there, I have a feeling he have 50% crew. We're aiming for lower plate, but you know, Ruski armor, and this time we are not getting spotted. By the way, we have a very, very solid lemming train in the beach, so keep that in mind. Well, not much what we can do about this, but hey, look, enemies are trying to make some kind of pressure in this side, and this T67 is showing his ass for, like, all enemies. He is trying to retreat faster, that's why he is doing that, and this is quite smart thing, I would say. Anyways, cover one is trying to make a pressure like this. I'm trying to find a shot on him. Hip hip hooray, 100 into the side, and this 100 alpha damage is pretty much standard in a tier 5, but I can tell you one thing. I did not enjoy this tank too much. I'm not saying it's a bad tank. I'm just saying it's not my style to snipe from the back. And if you are making pressure, you're going to take one for the team. It's no bueno. Also, I just missed that shot because I was thinking T67 went up so damn high. And I was thinking this guy is going to... this guy is simply going to keep going. But unfortunately, I was wrong. And this cover one did not manage to spot me once again. Okay, I want to relocate from there, because we don't really have too many forces which is playing in the Kilo Juliet line, okay? So we want to escape from there, that's why. And My main plan, my initial thought over there is to go for this KV1S and for that VK, and I believe that makes sense, right? But, wait for it. I am thinking about this KV1, I really am, but I don't really want to go for him. I think it's way too dangerous and way too risky. And we spotted the Mr. Archer with a bow, you know, like a Robin Hood, and Archer is going to have a good time. Archer, your time is over, you know. The bow and arrows is not working too well against the tanks, so have a nice day, mate. You are out of the game. Bye-bye. He is dying. Not much what he could do about that, and he made mistake. Right there, I am thinking about this VK, but I am loading gold ammunition right there, and I'm loading this gold ammunition for that KV1S. I'm thinking maybe he have some kind of crazy angle on me or something, so I am kind of prepared for that, but fellas, but it's not the case. So we are spotting him over there, like side of this tank. I track at him and we are loading standard ammunition because gold is not necessary. And in the same time, KV1S is not the tank which would have a lot of armor, just saying. By the way, this guy is going to have reaction of, I don't even know how to describe his reaction time, but it's no bueno. Anyways, we are just dropping on him and now we have his side. So all we need to do, we need to play smart, we need to farm his side. Yes, we had auto-aim and I could shoot him easily, but in the end of the day, I simply decided to finish him a proper way, if I can say so. Now I am thinking about dropping down here, and this is the situation when I will start doing mistakes, okay? This is the situation when I will start doing mistakes. S35 Psi is going on me. Unfortunately, I did not manage to penetrate the very first shot, and this is bad. We are trying to claim this guy life, and one more. Come on, we can finish him off. Yes, I see this T67. I see him. T67 made me down to the one shot, and greedy? No. He survived this, but hey, I have 48 hit points left, and it's not over till it's over, right? This guy tried to make... I am quite lucky he did not react right there. That was bad play by me, but let it be. And now we have three versus five situation. And I can tell you one thing, fellas. I'm not only one addicted for jumping. I can tell you that. The same. This KV1 is the same KV1 which was standing in the open field. Like this. The worst thing is they still have Artas. They have T-34, which is thinking about something very, very, very interesting. And this is a mistake which I am doing, fellas. Meanwhile, if you would pay attention right there, you would see the T-34 is having a very good time. I don't know. I have a feeling he's a diver, okay, from the big cliffs. So he was going like this and that did not work too well for this guy. Goodbye. Anyways, the biggest mistake which I made here, I was too confident this 60 is not going to 60G is not going to react properly, and I died, unfortunately, and we lost this battle because Artas is not going to win this. Basically, it's going to take a couple of minutes until Artas is going to die, so we are not going to watch this because it's kind of pointless, unless you want to see the super duper hyper turbo Artas speed. Vzhoom, 8 times faster. Greeley is going in front. Greeley is thinking, I'm going to sit here. Lev Hash is pushing in front too because he is saying, I have 20 kilometers per hour so I can deal with everyone. He did not manage to spot anyone but Lev Hash. Enemy Lev Hash is getting spotted. Greeley shot him too. Greeley managed to miss the shot on the tank destroyer, and our Lev Hash went in front just like this. 8x speed. Easy, fellas. Easy. I don't have anything to hide from you. And we are back with another replay, fellas. Panzer T25 Tier 5 shitter. I don't have anything to hide. As you can see, we have 100% on this vehicle already. And it was quite interesting gaming experience. When I tried to play with this tank aggressively, usually I was getting wrecked. That's what I said in the last replay, and I can repeat the same thing. So with this vehicle, you need to play safe. And the funny thing is, you need to play safe with majority of the tier 5 tanks in that way, at least when you are bottom tier. Cheers, fellas. That's what you need to do, because you don't have any other option. And if you are making some kind of pressure, since you don't have armor, you don't have insanely good gun handling, unless we are speaking about the T-67, but it's only, there is only a couple of rear tanks like this, right? Then, you know, it is a bit different situation, let's say like that. And, I used to enjoy the lower tiers quite a bit in the past, and now probably, I can tell you one thing, I do not enjoy playing the lower tiers that much. Who would ever expect that? But as you can see, it is the case. Or maybe I was playing with a wrong tank right there, and since we have a challenge, right, to deal with every single tank, and let's get real. Empire is not getting builded in one day or whatever, right? So same with this challenge, right? It's not happening that easy. It's just not happening like this. You need to play quite some games, and some tanks are going to be quite interesting for you to watch and for me to play, and some tanks is going to be meh. And what is your opinion about this tank? This is the question, fellas, because I know there is quite some people which bought this vehicle like long time ago, and which is maybe still enjoying this tank. Maybe I'm only one which do not had the best time ever. But by the way, fellas, we started already the Turan, which have 32 ammunition. So this vehicle compared to Turan, this tank is gold mine, and it's amazing. But once again, it's only me. What we are thinking in this battle, let's get into the game right there. I am thinking I want to get in front, right? And get some kind of sweet bush, so from there we can farm the enemy forces for obvious reasons, right? And as you can see, this Tiger is just taking one for the team. And the shots are not going that well for us, right? As you can see, RNG is a big factor of this game, and you simply cannot change anything. APCR penetration 167, standard penetration 100, and it's just simply, it is not really worth it to shoot the standard ammunition into the Tiger 131. Let's get real. And right there, both of our Ruski heavies died because they made a hardcore pressure for us, and if you would look there in the background, fellas, this is how you are not playing with IS when you are a top tier, okay? This is not the right play. But funny fact, I think we checked this person after the game, and he was a very new player. If I'm not mistaken, I might be wrong though. One or another way, it is how it is. Let's not look into the others. Let's look at ourselves, and let's try to get maximum use of this situation. So Tiger is pushing in front of us. They have a sniper schnitzel in the back, and with this Tiger I want to punish him once. I'm waiting for a good shot. We punished him, and now I'm running, right? I don't really want to F with this guy. It's just simply not worth it. Two Artas, sniper schnitzel MX, and it's just not worth for us to fight against the Tiger 131. I am taking way too much attention for myself, so it's simply not worth it. Instead of playing against this Tiger, right, fellas, we are going to flank the enemies. And once again, if you have mobility with a tier 5, tier 6, whatever, and you are a bottom tier, you can always flank. It goes for literally every single tank in the game, but you know, everything is coming with experience, fellas, and if you are not getting the results which you are dreaming about, which you want to get and so on, maybe you are a new player, or maybe you are missing some more experience, because every single person is learning the game in the different way, let's say like that. Someone can be very good player after 10,000 battles. Even though I think 10,000 battles is just a warming up for people which is playing World of Tanks. That's what I mean. And that's what I think. Anyways, In this position, fellas, we managed to outspot the MX. Now, just imagine, I am a tier 5 tank, and this MX is a tier 7 tank destroyer. He did not manage to spot me. You know why? First of all, I have camo on this tank. Camo skills. Second of all, he might be new player of the game, or he have a shitty ass crew, like 75% without binos, without anything, and it also could be a case. So one of the more important things in this game, fellas, you need to save credit somehow for the equipment. Equipment is giving you such a huge advantage. It's crazy what kind of advantage you can get with equipment, right? And you don't need to be like a player which is paying money for that. You can save up for binos for yourself, you can save up for the same camo net because it's for free, and so on, you know. So after that you can switch that to the other vehicles without any fee whatsoever. Anyways, look, we have high explosives right there. I'm trying to keep this guy in place, and there is Archer which is saying pir, which is trying to escape. We are hitting Archer right there, right in the face, right? And now we are still holding in place this Amex because I simply need to deal with him. And funny thing, I did not knew I can do damage for him in this angle, but as you can see, you can do this. Very, very nice. This battle, 1000 damage dealt, 800 assisting damage or tracking damage, however you are calling this, and we are just starting right here because enemies have the same T29 Arl, which I'm calling a donut for a reason. They have a light and they have Lightcher plus Archer plus 2 clickers. And now, fellas, one of the most important things when you are trying to hit actually, we are going to talk about that very, very soon. We have a side shot on the T29. Keep that in mind. And fellas, if you are thinking about snapping someone, I have an advice for you. This game is always listening to you. So if you want to snapshot someone, try to yell Russia. It can work very, very well, and I'm always laughing when it's actually working, even with the tanks which don't have the best accuracy. For example, this Panzer 25 don't have the best accuracy, or does it? I don't really think this tank have the best accuracy. In World of Tanks, at least, this vehicle trolled me quite a bit right there. And speaking of the snapshots, Russia! See, it works very, very fine. I have no clue what you are talking about, fellas. Easy game, easy. So, in this kind of situation, I am trying to figure out what do I really want to do here. Do I want to push on that donut? So, Arl, unfortunately, we missed the shot, and Arl started to make a pressure on us. Fair enough. RNG was definitely not in our side, and this Arl, he is punishing me for my stupidity, but once again, not much what I can do about that, and I'm accepting this. Another shot in front of the Arl, and now I'm thinking, do I want to let our clicker to click him, or do I want to take a shot and keep going and do more things for myself? You know what I decided? I decided to take one for the team, because it's just a in my opinion, it's just a good idea, right? We managed to bounce the Mr. Donut tank, but it's okay. After that, we finished him off. And yes, he cost some hit points for us, but, you know, I cannot change it. By the way, eventually we are going to try to mark the Arl V39, and I believe it's going to be very, very enjoyable stream. People which like to see me suffering, I believe you are going to have a good time. Obviously, it's not going to happen any day soon, but it's just for general information right there. And now we have Arta. In the last gameplay you saw, when I tried to ram Valentine, and I almost throw at this game, and you know what, once again I'm thinking about the same stuff. I can go for him, but I shitted my pants because I saw that Amax which is turning on me, so I thought no, I'm not going to take a risk, even though the other clicker Crusader SP did not had a shot, but hey, it's okay. And we finished this battle with a solid 2,600 for Mark of Excellence and 3,000 overall. Let's start this game. As you can see, IMD went down in this ditch and he changed his mind, so he is saying blah, 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 and he is trying to F off from here, and luckily we managed to punish him at least once, so I am not complaining too much, right? Meanwhile, the Sherman is trying to cross like this, and we just want to punish this guy here. And fellas, one more quick information for every single of you. If you are not familiar with our Rue server challenge, I can tell you one thing. In Rue server, right? Wait a second, looks like replay is a bit broken. How do you dear? Okay, if you are not familiar with this Russian challenge, right? My main goal is to get up to 100% on every single tank in the Rue server. So starting from tier 5, finishing to the tier 10. We did quite some stuff right here. We already have marked like close to 50 tanks up to 100%, and you are going to have a mixed stuff. You are going to have some lower tier gameplay, you will have some bigger tier gameplay, and the most recent tank which probably we are going to get Mark of Excellence on is going to be Pantera, P44 Pantera. This is the tank with which we are going to get up to 100% next, and after that, oh boy, we are going to play with a tier 9 Italian tank, which is going to be so much fun. Anyways, but for now, for today, we are playing with a T25, and this vehicle, speaking of this tank, fellas, in my opinion, this tank is a sniper, schnitzel, and nothing more. Yes, if you have good matchmaking, you can kind of go in front and you can flex a bit on the enemies. But usually, fellas, usually it is not the case. And when I played with this tank, I must admit, it's not my favorite tank, okay? This is the first thing which I want to say. Second thing is... with this tank, currently we are working this position out and we are just trying to punish those people which is playing over here, and I believe it's obvious, right? And whenever I was trying to make some kind of pressure with this vehicle, I usually was getting punished for my stupidity and for my mistakes. So this tank is like a sniper schnitzel, nothing more than that. By the way, this is a mistake which I'm doing. Looks is spotted, I'm peeking sideways, I want to hit this guy over here. I am taking one for the team even though I shouldn't, and our looks. He's trying to shoot from the 500 meters distance with his autoloader gun. By the way, he cannot even hit them. It's just not working like this, but it is how it is, right? For OI Experimental, fellas, we are loading APCRs right here because it's necessary, unfortunately. And I don't have all time in the world of tanks to shoot the standards and pray for RNGs to penetrate it. Unfortunately, I don't have this huge amount of the time. So far, it's already good. 1,300 damage and 100 tracking damage, I assume, or something like this, right? So I am already feeling very, very happy with it. And fellas, if my voice sometimes is changing, I apologize. I'm trying to do everything what I can, not too yavn. Shh, don't say that loud. So, from this position, as you can see, we have extremely good crossfire pretty much on everyone. We have a crossfire over there, we have crossfire over there, and it's just beautiful. We are leaving this Valentine with a 12 hit points, and in the end of the game you will see these hit points can be quite crucial. Anyways, right there, looks like our team is losing. They still have Oi, which have a lot of hit points left. So, I don't really want to go on him like this and, you know, just fight. No. We cannot do this kind of stuff, and I am trying to relocate a bit. This game is looking like we are about to lose this battle, to be honest. 7-9, okay, 8-9. They have Oi, which is extremely powerful, and probably you know what I'm talking about. And Matilda is getting spotted. Hello, sunshine. Since Matilda is getting spotted, we are trying to deal with it. By the way, Matilda is one of the dirtiest tier 4 tanks in the game, so keep that in mind. It's very, very dirty tank. And we are going with a couple of the blind shots right here and simply trying to get maximum use of all this. But, you know, unfortunately, it looks like we did not hit, we did not connect those blind shots. Well, better luck next time. Anyways, P43 tried to make some kind of pressure. And once again, I'm highlighting this tank. It is a sniper schnitzel. Same like Stug should be a sniper schnitzel, but apparently our Stug is sitting in the open field and he is having a good time right there, I assume. We are loading APCRs because I think we are going to see Oi soon. At least that's what I want to believe. And Stug, mate, what you are doing here? Don't you want to go back? I'm saying go back, Stug. And Stug is saying negative. I'm not joking. That's what Stug is saying. Okay. Maybe if he's happy with his position, let it be. I cannot change it, fellas. I just can't. And enemies started to cap the base. Someone from the enemies is capping base. I want to believe, fellas. I want to believe. It is Valentine or Oi. 1 out of 2, because Matilda probably did not relocated like this, and probably Matilda is not the one which is capping. So what we want to do now, we have some artists which could decap Oi, and I want to figure out where exactly he is. Oh yes, and Oi is actually capping the base. Everything is fine, roger that. And what we are doing here, we are trying to make some kind of crossfire. Arta decapped this guy, hip hip hooray. And now our almighty Stug is joining us. I don't have too much hopes with this guy, because he was sitting like literally in the open field for the past couple of minutes. So, you know, not too much expectations right there. And you know what? Oi made a crucial mistake. Oi tried to shoot, and this is it for Mr. Oi. We are going on his side with APCRs, but skill, why you are spamming APCRs, fellas? This is one of the most broken tanks in the game. What do you expect me to do? To throw potatoes at it or what? This is the right way to deal with Oi, and I would highly recommend for every single of you. If you are going to see Oi in the battlefield, tap that 2 key and smile. And look how his hit points is disappearing, you know? This is the thing. And right here, fellas, we are going to relocate a bit, so let's speed up the replay. Ferrari mode activated. This is a very good thing to mention, fellas. Do you see this Valentine which is spotted over there? I'm ignoring him because Arta can rebalance me, so I'm relocating for Arta. I'm saying goodbye for Valentine. Have a nice day. And we are going for that clicker. Pay attention to what we have right here. We have a high explosive loaded, right? What that basically means, we can two-shot Arta instead of three-shotting it. Arta just shot, so there is no danger whatsoever for me, and Arta killed the Stug, but I killed this guy. And now, all we need to do, we need to go and claim the Valentine's life, right? All we need to do. And, fellas, you know, I have a couple of addictions, one for jumping, another for running. So there is only one thing which I am thinking now, the same Valentine with 14 hit points. Ram. That's what I'm thinking now, and pay attention, I almost messed up right there. I'm going for him, super speed, I'm going for him, and I rammed him for 4. I actually rammed this guy for 4. I was very, very close to throw this battle, but hey, luckily that was not the case, and we won this game with 2.4 thousand damage, 400 assisting damage. And in this battle, fellas, we was very, very, very close to get Mark of Excellence on this vehicle. We was on 99.8 or something like this. We was extremely close. So we basically needed to, get approximately, okay, Mark of Excellence mod is in. Well, that kind of stuff is happening. The thing is, we needed, like, to stay on the same, we needed 1,200. So if we are getting 1,500, we pretty much secured the mark. But the funniest thing of all this, well, we will talk about that very, very soon. First of all, I mentioned you that to you many, many, many times before. This tank is a sniper schnitzel when it's bottom tier for sure. So, yeah, kind of boring gameplay, and probably you completely understand why I did not like it this tank, because you are super duper hyper turbo slow and it's just annoying. Meanwhile, our Arta is having quite a good time while, I don't even know, traveling, but luckily he noticed it in time. He needs to F off, so he is pir going back pretty much, right? Good. Our M4 is saying push with me, and I'm saying no, and I'm not going to push in front. And now we are going to have a sniper schnitzel festa with a wheeled Ferraris. And funny story with all this, fellas, before I marked this tank up to 100%, for the last couple of battles I saw 69 everywhere. 69 damage dealt, 69 assisting damage, 69 in my head. Wherever I was looking at, it was 69. And you know what is the funniest thing? We marked this tank in 69 battles. We got up to 100% in 69 battles. Yes, I know, hacker, a hacker, fellas. Or maybe I'm supposed to say naughty skill. Yeah, maybe. You never know, fellas. One or another way, it is how it is. And right there, we managed to get a couple of the free shots on the people which played in the open field right there for those wheeled Ferraris, or however you are calling that. It doesn't matter, right? And this battle itself was not super duper hyper turbo good, and you will see that very, very soon. Why so? Unfortunately, but sometimes stuff like this is happening when enemies have no team whatsoever. And if enemy team don't, if they are not playing very well, you know, it's complicated. By the way, this is going to be beautiful. No, no, not this one. This one will be beautiful. He's dead. That was a luck. It was good aiming. It was a bit of the RNG. But everything worked in our favor. So I'm feeling very, very good. So far, 403-2. So it's not looking that terrible yet, but wait, fellas. Soon you will figure out how the things are going and how everything is looking like. EBR is in the right side over there, and I am trying to eliminate him. Unfortunately, I managed to hit his wheel and he is dead, so we are not getting any assisting damage whatsoever. We are trying to shoot this T-34-85, and we managed to get quite some use. Currently, the score is 5-2. We have only 600 and 100. And now I can't say I started panicking, but I started to think what I supposed to do. Because if I won't do anything, it's going to be very bad. And as you can see, we did not manage to punish this cover one, which was going in front, right? And it's quite sad thing, but not much what I can do about this. So score is 5-3, and look at the positions. Our team is just going on the enemies very, very, very hard, and I need to think what I'm going to do. But before everything, I want to see this IMD. Enemy is getting spotted right there. Lightweight Yolka, well, not lightweight, sorry, the ELC MX Bis, the Yolka, or however you are calling that vehicle. But he is dying. Hip hip hooray. And now, fellas, the real colors of this happened showed, right? We see 9-3 score, and we need to do everything what we can. Let's speed this up. We are going in front very, very aggressively right there, and I'm loading APCRs because I can smell the gun mark percentage getting there. And you know what? We are spotting the cover one, which is sitting right there. I was lucky enough, I punished this guy, and in the same time I noticed that the Arta is just making a hardcore pressure. And the last hope for us, fellas, is this Bled Prince. We are very, very close to get Mark of Excellence. We are extremely close, but we need to get a couple of shots more, right? And if I remember everything properly right here, fellas, in this battle, right, I was getting very, very close to get Mark of Excellence right here, and there was one blind shot. Remember into the guy which went like full YOLO while saying blah, 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 and so on. And you know what is the funniest part of all this? That guy which went completely YOLO, well, which tried to escape and which I managed to catch when he is running, right? He was our 100% of the mark of excellence shot. So basically, we stayed on the same and tiny touch raised in this battle, but that one shot for that guy, which was running away, he basically earned us the 100% of the mark of excellence. That's it. So what can I say about the tier 5 in general? Fellas, tier 5 is not very challenging for me to get up to 100% of the mark of excellence, but challenge is challenge, and I am going to do with this. I'm going to deal with it. I am trying to avoid it as much as I can, but fellas, once again, who do not enjoy the lower tier gameplay or something, you can always skip the video and you are not forced to watch that, and I must share that with you, right? So yeah, that was a 100% mark of excellence on T25, and you know what, I'm super happy we don't need to play with this vehicle again. So you are not going to see this tank very, very soon in this YouTube channel, you can be sure about that. Thank you so much for watching. It was a pleasure for me to witness everything once again, how we are getting Mark of Excellence up to 100%, and we don't need to play with this tank ever again. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time, fellas. Peace.